Morning, everyone. And today we will deal with the last part of the unit first, and then I will move towards one poem. It's called The Banyan Tree, written by Dilip Chitre. He is an Indian writer, poet. So let's see the last part of the unit one. So, problem words. In this unit, developing vocabulary, we understood that English language had so many rules, regulations, but if you understand those rules and rules properly, then it will be very easy, like our mother tongue. But those rules are very important. You should learn it and you should understand it. Means, if you violate the rules of any language, then that won't be a language. That won't create a good meaning if you violate the rule of a language. So let's see what is problem words. Problem words means they look alike or sound alike. Or maybe there are so many different words for the same meaning. But you should understand first that those words have particular meaning in a particular context. Let me give an example of look, watch, see. See, look and watch. S-E-E-C-L-O-O-K, look. W-A-T-C, watch, observe. What we observe, what we see, what we look at, what we watch is the same thing. But its context is different. Then there are another example, hear and listen. It seems that the meaning is same, but in context they differ a lot. So in problem words, some words in English look alike or sound alike. Ek sarke distat ki wahan ka ek shabdan sa pronunciation hai same hoon jata. These words create confusion and we avoid using them. So, what these words do? They create confusion. And we avoid using them. So, in rich vocabulary, it is necessary to learn them and use them correctly. For example, adapt means make suitable for. We adapted ourselves to the what weather. म्हणजे त्या परिसराशी मिळते जुळते करून घेणं, त्याच्यामध्ये सामील होणं, त्यामध्ये मिक्स होणं. देन अडॅप्ट. अडॅप्ट मीन्स स्किल्ड. ही इज अन अडॅप्ट इन द आर्ट ऑफ स्टीलिंग. तो चोरण्यामध्ये खूप पटाईत आहे, चलाक आहे. अडॉप्ट. अडॉप्ट मीन्स टेक. मिस्टर दराडे हॅज अडॉप्टेड अ गर्ल चाइल्ड. So this is the difference. Some words look alike or sound alike, but they have a different context. Then alternate, one after the another. Alternative, twice. We are called an alternative day for football practice. We are called an alternative day for a football practice. Then alternative. Twice. There is no alternative before us but to accept the condition. So this is the difference between these two words. Then birth. Then this birth. Birth that we have in railways or in any tourist vehicles. They got 5 berths reserved for Mumbai, a sleeping place. Birth, being born. The old man doesn't know its exact birth date. Then desert and desert. Desert means to leave. They deserted the country for 2 years. Then desert, sweet dish. जसं आपण जेवण केल्यानंतर करतो दैट इज स्वीट डिश. नाउ दिस इज व्हाट द प्रॉब्लम वर्ड्स आर हियर. आई हैव कंप्लीटेड द फर्स्ट यूनिट. नाउ वी विल डिस्कस द पोयम द बनियान ट्री. The falling of the banyan tree. It's failing written, but actually it is the falling of a banyan tree. म्हणजे त्या बनियान ट्रीच पडणं पाडणे. इट इज रिटन बाय दिलीप चित्रे वॉज बॉर्न इन बरोदा. ही रोट पोएम्स इन मराठी एंड इंग्लिश. He is one of the major postmodern poets in Marathi literature. He depicted the village and cultural life of Marathi people through his poems that left a great impact of the development of Marathi literature in particular. So basically, he is a Maharashtrian. He wrote in Marathi as well as is in English, and he depicted the village life as well as the cultural life of Marathi people. His literary works are celebrated with national and international awards like Sahitya Academy Award for his Marathi poetry. His translation works of Sant Tukaram's Abhangs is known as his greatest literary works. To learn his poems becomes a journey to culture and tradition. Through his images, the present poem, The Falling of the Banyan Tree, the Failing of the Banyan, I was wrong, The Failing of the Banyan Tree, is published in his work ट्रॅव्हलिंग इन अ केज इन 1980. या पोयम मध्ये किंवा दिलीप चित्रेचे जी काही थीम आहे प्रत्येक पोयमची, इट इज रिलेटेड टू द लाईफ ऑफ अ कॉमन मॅन हू इज लिव्हिंग इन द विलेजेस ऑफ महाराष्ट्र. इट डिपिक्ट द कल्चरल लाईफ, देअर हॅबिट्स. सो दिस इज द इश्यू ऑफ एव्हरी वन हू आर लिव्हिंग ऑन अर्थ. In this poem, we will see the same issue. He got many awards. One of the best award of in literature in India is Sahitya Academy Award. Now, in this poem, we can see culture as well as tradition, and he has that quality to tackle that issue. Means he beautifully characterized those images, and we can observe or we can see that we are connected to those images directly or indirectly. Now about this poem, in this poem we see the clash between culture, tradition, not between culture and tradition, cultural tradition versus modernization. Due to modernization, we are living a good life, but still we are facing some issues. That issue is environmental issue, and this poem actually about environment. It is about our ecology, and we see that if we differentiate our life, or we differentiate our life from our environment, then it will be so hectic for us. So we should be living with our nature. We should rear it, we should care it, and then only we can live a happy life. Now I'm starting this poem. My father told the tenants to leave. Here tenants means जे मजूर असतात किंवा जे कुळाने लोक राहतात त्यांना टेनन्स म्हणतात किंवा भाडेकरू हे म्हणू शकतो. माय फादर टोल्ड द टेनन्स टू लीव. माय फादर टोल्ड दोज टेनन्स टू लीव द हाऊस. टू लीव ऑन द हाऊस हाऊसेस सराउंडिंग अवर हाऊस ऑन द हिल. दे वर लिव्हिंग around our house, so he told them to leave the houses. One by one, the structures were demolished. Only our home, house remained and the trees. One by one, the structures here, houses, were demolished. Demolished manje udvast karne, padne. After leaving the tenants, father ordered to demolish those houses. Only our own house remained and the trees. Trees are sacred, my grandmother used to say. His grandmother, the poet's grandmother, always used to say that trees are very sacred. Felling them is a crime, but he massacred them all. Manje, त्या झाडांना तोडणं हा खूप मोठा गुन्हा होता. बिकॉज ट्रीज आर व्हेरी सेक्रेड. सेक्रेड म्हणजे रिलिजियसशी रिलेटेड असतात. काही 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 झाड हे धर्माशी रिलेटेड असतात. सो दे आर व्हेरी सेक्रेड. सो बट हिज फादर ऑर्डर देम टू कट इट डाऊन. सो फेलिंग देम इज अ क्राईम. त्यांना तोडणं हा एक गुन्हा आहे. बट ही मॅसेकर्ड देम ऑल. मॅसेकर्ड मीन्स कत्तल करणे. पण इथं झाडाची कत्तल नाही, तिथं पूर्ण ती झाड तोडून टाकली गेली. बट ही मॅसेकर्ड देम ऑल. द शेवगा, द औदुंबर, द नीम वर ऑल कट डाऊन. बट द ह्यूज बनियन ट्री स्टूड लाईक अ प्रॉब्लेम. जी काही शेवग्याची झाड होती, औदुंबर म्हणजे उंबराची झाड होती, लिंबाची झाड होती, सर्व तोडून टाकले. बट देअर इज वन प्रॉब्लेम, दॅट्स बनियन ट्री. बिकॉज इट वॉज ह्यूज. तो बनियन ट्री खूप मोठा होता. आणि त्याच गोष्टीचा त्या वडिलांना जरा थोडा प्रॉब्लेम झाला. हूज रूट्स ले डीपर दॅन ऑल अवर लाईफ. दिस लाईन हॅज लॉट ऑफ इम्पॉर्टन्स हिअर. हूज रूट्स ले डीपर दॅन ऑल अवर लाईफ. बिकॉज इट वॉज सो ओल्ड. हिअर their lives means their ancestors were living there. Now the houses around them were destroyed or demolished. Now they are moving towards city. So this is the issue. This is the cultural clash. This is the clash between time. My father ordered it to be removed. So his father ordered it to be removed. तरीही पोएटच्या वडिलांनी आदेश दिला की तुम्ही ते झाड लवकरात लवकर तोडून टाका, त्याला बाजूला काढून टाका. The banyan tree was 3 times as tall as our house. Now see, look at the size of the banyan tree. It was so big. It was 3 times bigger than their house. Now, see, in modernization, we are having this issue. We don't want to go to our roots. Here, roots means mulan ahe. Aplya patimaga kay chalela ahe. Mhanje apan past madhe kay hoto, yacha apan kadhi vichar karat nahi. We should understand the past. If we observe our past and if we cleared our mistakes in the past, then our future becomes secure. म्हणजे काय, जे आपण भूतकाळात केलेल्या चुका असतील त्या आपण क्लिअर केल्या, त्यांना व्यवस्थित योग्य केलं, तर आपला प्रेझेंट अँड फ्युचर व्यवस्थित बनू शकतो. अदरवाइज वी विल रिमेंबर दोज थिंग्स, द पास्ट इश्यूज. सो दिस इज द कल्चरल क्लॅश बिटवीन टाइम. Between the two times or three generations. So with this note, I am concluding my lecture today. Tomorrow we will finish this poem. Till now, thank you.